it with a thunderbolt, but he really didn't. So I do know that it's appropriate to thank him for his goodness and mercy.
Yes, amen.
And appreciate what God is allowing us to do together.
Yes. Amen.
Appreciate the words of life. Because if I was listening with my heart, and I was, Sister Grant, I was listening with my heart.
Yes.
Man, the scripture says that man or we look at the mm-hmm. outward appearance.
Yes. Yes.
But we're not to look
mm-hmm.
at that.
Mm-mm.
We are to look at the inside. Because that's how
Amen.
Jesus does
yes,
it.
Yes, yes, it is.
And it seemed to me that she was saying, let's find a better way.
Yes.
I mean, what good does it do if we're all scattered? It really doesn't.
Yes, right.
It really doesn't. And I would like to feel the fan yes. of the Lord.
Amen.
I'd like to feel the
yes,
fan
Lord,
today.
Yes,
and I'd like
Amen.
It to stir up
Amen.
The gift that's in me.
Amen.
I'd like it to
Amen.
Stir up the gift that's in you.
Yes.
So there's a better
yes,
way
yes,
of doing
yes,
things.
There is. Yes,
I read this morning about does the brain cells, when it's below zero outside, do they freeze up? Just a question. And then when it's very hot outside, does your brain fry? Well, really, both of those conditions could happen unless we had a regulator inside.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And we have a
yes.
regulator.
Oh, yes,
and if you
do.
Put your hand
yes,
on your forehead
mm-hmm.
or your finger, put your other finger on the back of your head,
mm-hmm.
then come about two-thirds up,
mm-hmm.
and deep down above the spinal cord, there is something called the hypothalamus.
Mm-hmm.
And that is our regulator.
Yes,
now,
yes,
if I will put my hands up
yes,
and
Lord.
Try
yes.
to get connected,
yes, yes,
the
yes,
regulator
yes,
can
yes,
come
Lord.
In and keep me
yes.
at the temperature that I am supposed to be.
Yes.
I
yes.
love yes. the Word of God, and this, as what Sister Grant was talking about, was a better way.
Amen.
There's
yes.
an old country song, and maybe you know it, maybe you don't. It really, but the words in it say something to the effect that I can be a better man because of, and of course it gives a long string of stuff,
mm-hmm.
but we can be better in
yes.
Christ
Amen.
If we then try to get a hold of the source.
Amen.
We can be better.
Yes.
We can be profitable.
Yes.
We can show the
Amen.
Love of God in
Absolutely.
Our heart
yes.
toward one another.
Amen.
I have love. Brother Zonneville talked about it Friday night.
Mm-hmm.
If you missed it, you missed it. Anyway, he talked about love, and it's love
Amen.
To, I have love to you. That's like having a dollar bill and giving it to you. But having love for you is like I'm
yes.
over here. Well, I got it for you. You over yonder, and I'm over here.
Right.
That's a funny kind of love.
Mm-hmm.
Just think about it. It's
yes.
a funny
yes.
kind of love. So we are trying to learn scriptorial
Amen.
How
yes.
to be
yes, yes.
in a better way.
Yes.
Amen.
And if I'm thinking about a scripture, and I'm thinking about a scripture, I really was. It's in the Psalms. It's in the Psalms. It's
that's the Lord.
Hmm? About it's better, the better something. I'll find it. It's better. Yeah. Here. I'll start here until I find it. How's that be? Give thanks. Oh, I'm sorry. 118. I have my Bible color coded. Really, and I'm looking for a new Bible. I guess it was this past week, and I'm looking for one. I want one like the one that I carry here all the time. This is my study Bible by my chair, but I couldn't find it, so I said, okay, enough of that. Anyway, Psalms 118 and 1 says, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and because his mercy endureth. Now here's where I want to be, though. Psalms 118 and 8. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. No matter how good a person is at whatever they do in life, it's talking about the anointing of God. You have to be anointed of God
yes,
in order to put any confidence in what the fella is saying. Now, anointed of God doesn't always mean that you're jumping up and down.
Absolutely.
It doesn't.
Yes,
but there is something that would touch your spirit from the Word of God, and you know that it's God telling you about it.
Amen.
It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princesses or things of this life. A prince is nothing but a high person under a kingship. All right, let's go to Proverbs, the next one, the next place over, the next book over, I think, and it's 16 and 9 or 19. Better it is to be of a humble spirit with the lowly than to divide the spoils with the proud.
Mm-hmm.
And he that handleth the matter wisely shall find good.
Mm.
And whosoever trusteth in the Lord, whoever trusts in God, happy is he.
Amen.
And I've thought about the last few weeks. You know, our family has problems, and they're going to be there.
Yeah.
But how much more I have been above that. I have been above that. And you know who helped you? Who can help you get above all that?
Amen.
His name is Jesus.
He will show me
a better way if I'll allow it.
Yes.
But then what happens, you think you get on the subject or whatever's going on at home, you get on that and you dwell on it and you dwell on it and you dwell on it.
Yeah. Yes.
And that's easy to do because I'm human and I'm flesh.
Yes.
But if I can get elevated,
yes,
because Jesus shows us a better way.
Mm-hmm.
And he, Brother Wallace said Friday night, he is in the upland.
Yes,
he is down here.
Yes,
he's in the upland. Mm-hmm. So I got to get my spirit lifted up so I can do what he'd like me to do. Then go to Proverbs 21 and 9 or 7. 21. It is better to dwell in the corner of a housetop than with a brawling woman in a wide house.
Mm.
And of course, you know in Matthew it talks about that wide way.
Yeah.
And I'd rather be in a corner in God's house.
Yes.
I'd rather be like David said, I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of the Lord than to dwell in the tents of the ungodly.
Mm-hmm.
How fortunate we are.
Yes.
See, that's that is Jesus showing David a better way. That was Jesus showing David a better way. How he'd much rather be the doorkeeper in the house of the Lord than to dwell in the tents of the ungodly.
Yes.
This is such a good, interesting book.
It is.
It was written many years ago, but did you know there's still life in it?
Yes,
good literature never goes out of date. Good literature never goes out of date. And I don't know if this is called literature or not, but it is. It's soul saving.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
It's soul saving.
Yes,
it goes from here to eternity. This will go right into eternity with us, because what we hide in our heart, the Word of God, it goes right on forever. It goes right on forever. It doesn't go by the way of dust or the grave. This is such a good, interesting book.
Yes, it is.
I was up once again this morning, and I was studying on Melchizedek again. I ought to have him down good, because that's what I was studying.
Yeah.
I love this way, and the reason I love this way is because I was taught to follow in the ways that Jesus would have you go. Because it's a better way. It's a better way. There's nothing wrong with his way. And then in the New Testament, two more scriptures. I know it's in Matthew where it says about if your eye offends you, pluck it out. And if your hands offend you, cut them off. And if your feet offend you, you know, does it say chop them off? I can't remember. That's in Matthew. Does anybody know where in Matthew? Is it 15? I wanted to read it because of the wording is what I wanted to read. What is it? Okay. If thy right hand offend thee, cut it off and cast it from thee. For it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish, and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell. Okay, that is the one, but that is not the one I'm thinking of. There is one that I am thinking of. Yeah. Where's it at?
It's just the verse before.
Oh, wait a minute, there. And if thy right eye, there it is, that's what I was thinking of. And if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out and cast it from thee. For it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish, and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell. So if my eye, if my vision, there's something wrong with my vision, and I am not sitting in the right place, there's something would be wrong with my vision. Jesus isn't telling me to poke my eye out. He's telling me to get a better way. That's what I was trying to get to. He's telling me a better way. How to get to what that means. How to get to understand what that means. And Jesus does not mean for you to chop off your foot. What he wants you to do, he wants you to walk in the direction. He wants you to walk in this direction. And I'm not talking about what I'm saying. The direction, the course that the scripture leads you in. I am so amazed that those prophets, I don't know if any of them went to college, have no idea. But they were so smart. But the scripture said that they were holy men of old and spake as the Holy Ghost lit upon them. And did you know how important it is for the Holy Ghost to light on you and I?
Yes, it is.
In every aspect of our life, the Holy Ghost needs to light on you. Whether you are taking your mother to the doctor, or whether you and your neighbor are having a problem, even though the neighbor's in one area and you're another, the Holy Ghost has to light on our mind so we will find a better way to resolve or figure out the problem. I so appreciate, and Sister Tammy put this in my heart this morning, there's a better way of doing things. There must be a song, I don't know that there is, but there must be a song, there's a better way. There's a better way, and I'm glad this morning that you and I are learning to travel and learning to lean to that better way.
Yes.
Had it not been for Jesus, I would not see, and neither would you, how good it is to be in a place where it's seeking a better way.
How good it is.